this is Victoria, and welcome to another episode of Bake Dance, where we'll be making recipes baked in the oven, whether savory or sweet, accompanied by songs I love and inspire me. First, let me start this episode by saying I have never been on MasterChef. I will never be on MasterChef, but this is a gift given by a dear and beloved friend of mine who used to handle the TV rights for Greece. Bea, thank you, love you. And it's gonna come in really handy today because we're gonna get a little bit messy. We're gonna be making pizza from scratch. So today we're gonna be making pizza alla Napoletana, one of my favorite pizza pies. So first we're gonna start with the dough, the most important part of a pizza. The first thing that we're gonna need is 3/4 of a cup, about 45 degrees Celsius, 3 tablespoons olive oil, 3/4 of a teaspoon salt, 1 teaspoon sugar, 1 pack of dry yeast, and 2 cups of flour. Ideally, we would be using doppio zero flour, which is 00 flour, super fine and super thin, and makes for the perfectly thin crust. I didn't have that today, but I think we're gonna do a good job with the all-purpose flour that I used. So the first thing that we're gonna do is take our warm water, check it that it's at 45 degrees Celsius, and our packet of yeast, and stir that, and let it stand for about 5 minutes until the yeast dissolves. And then next, what we're gonna do is take a bowl, and you just wanna brush it all over with olive oil. Okay, now we're gonna use our beloved trusty KitchenAid. So combine the flour, the sugar, and the salt. Now we're gonna go ahead and add our olive oil and our yeast and water mixture. And put your mixture on medium until it forms a sticky ball. All right, so now you're gonna wanna transfer your dough to a lightly floured surface. I always go a little bit overboard here because I'm so fortunate to have this beautiful granite countertop to work with and have fun on. All right, so now you're gonna take your dough that's turned into a ball, and you're gonna put it on your floured surface and knead it until the dough is smooth. We have a nice ball, and we're gonna put it into our oil bowl and flip it around so that you coat it fully in olive oil. Finally, we're gonna cover the dough in plastic wrap and let it sit in a warm, draft-free area while it rises about double in volume for about an hour. Some people crush the tomatoes. Personally, I like to cut them in half and de-seed and then drain them. Now that we've sliced our tomatoes, like I said before, ideally they would be San Marzano tomatoes, but if you can't find them, use something similar. Any kind of cherry tomato will do. So now that our tomatoes are graining, we're gonna do the same thing with our mozzarella. We have 4 big, beautiful balls of buffalo mozzarella that we're gonna slice and drain. 10 points to any fan who knows why we're draining our ingredients. I've said it 1,000 times. No one likes a soggy pie. Look at that beauty. Gorgeous. And now we're gonna turn it into a pizza pie. And before we do that, let's preheat our oven. We're gonna get her nice and high at 230 Celsius. Flour our surface once again. And take out, if you have any anger or frustration, this is when you punch it. Now you don't wanna overwork your dough. Normally I just roll it out, but I'm feeling kind of playful. What do you think, 2 hands? No?
Again.
Now you guys see why I need this MasterChef apron? Evidently I got some on my face too. Now I wanna prepare the pan. Go ahead and lightly drizzle it with olive oil. Personally, I like dusting it also with some polenta. Get that on the bottom of the crust. And take your dough and place it gently on the pan. It's gonna be very sensitive because we've rolled it really thin. I know before I was preaching about the quality of ingredients. Ideally here we would have a homemade tomato sauce, but I found one at the store that's just as good. So I'm gonna put just a little bit. It has a little bit of basil in here, and afterwards we're gonna put some fresh basil too. So it's gonna tie all the flavors together. Next, we're gonna place our tomatoes. Making pizza, eating pizza always brings me back to my days in New York. where the New York slice was one of my favorite meals to be enjoyed breakfast, lunch, evening, in the wee hours of the morning after bar hopping in the East Village. And now top it off with your mozzarella slices. Time to go into the oven. Be sure to place it in the lower third part of the oven because we want to get that bottom extra crispy and extra golden brown while giving the ingredients on top time to catch up. So normally about now, I'd be pouring myself a nice glass of wine. But today I think I'm gonna wash up and make a nice Campari. All right, clean myself up a little bit. So it's been in for about 7 minutes. So I'm gonna change the heat to just the lower heat, and I'm gonna increase the heat to 250. So I think today we'll make a nice light Campari with a little bit of orange juice. I love my bitters. Perfectly crispy. And now we're gonna take our fresh basil. Nothing like the smell of fresh basil. And tear and sprinkle all over the top. Oh, it smells so good. A little bit of sea salt from the Sea of Chios. Oh, perfect, listen to that. Smells delicious, guys. Thanks for watching, everyone. Don't forget to follow me on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and to subscribe to my YouTube channel. Buon appetit, cari orexi, a fietal soon. See you next time.